Welcome to the Athlete to Athlete series, where we bring together current and former athletes to exchange tips, tools, and powerful information that will help you on and off the field. My name is Rennie Curran. I'm a former professional athlete and the CEO of the Game Changers Foundation. Welcome to the Athlete to Athlete series. Our next guest on the Athlete to Athlete series came straight out of Florida from Plant High School. For you Georgia fans, you guys might remember a guy who he played along with, Aaron Murray. They came in the University of Georgia and did a lot of great things. So we have with us today none other than former professional athlete, tight end, Orson Charles, man. Orson, what's going on, bro?
My guy, it was good.
Good.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, sir. Appreciate you being on, man. Mm-hmm. So one question I always like to ask, man, is just, tell us about your high school experiences, man, and you know, just some of the great things that happened.
So obviously one of the great things that happened, we won a national championship, we won a state title.
Okay.
And that was a roller coaster. A lot of people don't understand the ups and downs we had to go through in order to get that, but us coming together, you know, us forming that team, us playing with each other, us, yeah. You know, that brotherhood is something that you cannot find. Mm. We formed that and we was able to go to states.
Love it, man.
And win it.
All right, so you talked about the success, man. What's a major challenge that you faced during your high school years, man, and how were you able to overcome it?
So one of my major challenges, I mean, I look back at it and I'm very grateful. My mom was so strict, you know, us being from the island, our island mom was so strong and strict.
Yeah.
So we had to do chores, it was homework, school, and then come back home.
Yeah.
So looking back, or when I was younger, I just thought that I had to be with everybody else. Like after the game, they would go out and party or do X, Y, and Z. And my mom was at the parking lot waiting for me, hey, we're going home. So I think just understanding that you don't have to do what everybody else is doing if you have a clear vision and path of what you want to achieve and do.
Love it, man, love it. That's super important. Man, next question I have for you, man, is, you know, we got a lot of high school athletes watching right now. Some of them aren't playing, they're getting ready for the game, they're getting their minds right. So what was your pregame ritual, man, the things you did to get you in that state of mind to be that champion?
Mm-hmm. So Clint, Coach Wiener, and Coach Lane, they had a ritual for us to do. Like we couldn't leave school. All we had to do was stay there, study, and then, you know, eat, have that pregame meal. So after I get done eating, I'm just reviewing the plays. I'm going on the field, walking through all the routes, walking through all the plays, and just getting my mind ready for battle. Because essentially, that's really what it is. And then when the lights come on, you're not thinking. You're just reacting. You're just going and playing ball and just having fun.
Yeah.
So I think all the athletes, I'll tell them just to make sure you have a routine on what you want to do, achieve, review your plays, and just go out there and have fun.
Love it, man. What's that pregame song that gets you fired up, man?
Oh, it's different. So. Right before the game, I love listening to gospel. Love listening to gospel to calm my mind down.
Yeah.
Just being grateful to play the game, because a lot of people is unfortunate to play the game. And then I'll listen to some reggae, because you know that's who we're used to listening to. Okay. And then by that time, it's ready to play. So
yeah.
I don't need no music. I'm already turned up.
I love it, man. I love it. So tell me about all the teams that you were able to play on beyond high school.
So went to high school and then went to UGA. After UGA, got drafted by Cincinnati, went to New Orleans, Detroit, Kansas City, Cleveland, and then ended with Denver.
So wow.
Been around.
Yeah, man, been around. And you know, the reason why I asked you that, man, is there's a lot of high school athletes who are watching this show right now who want to know what it takes to get to that highest level. So what are some of the things that you did, man, that helped set you apart and prolonged your career?
Being able to adjust and change. Mm. Because when I first got in, I was tight end, and then like towards, you know, the end of that year and the next year, they wanted to look for the Travis Kelce, the Gronk. So I'm only 6'3", so they moved me to fullback. And at the time, I did not like it, but it prolonged my career. Mm. But if I was stubborn and was like, hey, I don't want to do that, I probably would have made it 7 years. So being able to adjust, being able to adapt, and just don't be scared to ask your coach, hey coach, what can I do better? A lot of people don't accept criticism.
Wow.
And that's the only way to get better. And just understanding the playbook and knowing that you have to take this game very seriously, because it can be taken away from you just like that.
Powerful, man. You mentioned a lot of great things. You mentioned adjusting to change, transitioning, you know, handling criticism, understanding that the game can be taken away at any time, and just, you know, taking that a step further, man. Now that you are done playing, you retired not too long ago, what are some of the things that you're doing now, and what advice would you give to those guys as they prepare with that transition, which we all face?
So right now I'm a builder. So I build new homes, new construction, fix and flip. I'm an investor. I have a gym in Tampa. And then I have my hand in a couple of other things that I'm trying to get off the ground. And one thing that I would tell anybody transitioning out of the lead is surround yourself with people that was there from the beginning and get yourself in church, because we all need God and we all need therapy. I definitely believe that that helps, because we've done something for so long and all of a sudden it's over. That's a huge transition into going into the real world. So you have to surround yourself with people you love. Luckily enough, God blessed me with mentors. I had my pastor in my corner, my family. Right. So it was hard, but it was easier having them with me.
Gotcha, man. I love it. You're exactly right. Faith, therapy, all those things, man. Surrounding yourself with the right people.
It's essential.
Yeah, huge, man. So last question I have, man, as we wrap things up, what's that big play that you remember, man, that just, like, when you think about it, it was like everything, man. It was that moment, that it moment where it was like, man, I got some. You know what I mean? What's that big play that you can remember from high school?
From high school?
Yeah.
So the big play from high school, I believe when Aaron went down, we was playing Hillsboro. It was either Hillsboro or Chamberlain. Aaron broke his ankle.
Dang.
Like, went down completely. We knew that we needed Aaron in order to get to the state. And we walked Aaron to the locker room. I had to make sure my guy was okay. And then when we came out, I was like, hey, like, we have to continue to keep playing our best to get to the state so Aaron can, you know, help us win the state. So we had Philip Ely. He was a sophomore at the time. He was real small. And it was this play called Double Zone. Double Zone is all verts. And I believe it was single high. I was matched up one-on-one. So he already knew just to throw it. He threw it. I caught the ball. And then that set the whole tempo for the rest of the season as far as, hey, we're still here. We'll continue to keep fighting for our guys so you can come back and we'll win the whole thing.
Love it, man. Love those key moments.
You never forget
them. That's the beauty of high school ball, man. All these athletes who are watching, man, like, I always tell them the biggest thing you can have when it's all over is those memories, especially moments like that, man. So appreciate you being on the show,
thank
man.
Thank you for having me.
And got a special prize for you for being a part of this, man.
Let's go.
So Orson, man, we appreciate you being on the show for all the knowledge that you just shared. Wish you continued success. And as a special thank you, man, we just want to give you these headphones. We got you the red ones.
I'm a picture, Jabra,
one of our sponsors, man. So yeah, that's you, man.
Thank you.
Appreciate
thank you. Thank you.
Being on.
Thank you. Much love, sir. My guy.
Oh yeah. No dog.
No dog.
Athlete to Athlete, presented by SportsTurf Company and the Game Changers Foundation.